Disclaimer time, Toho belongs to Zune. Any pictures, videos, or music here belong to their respective owners. So let's get this started. From bakeries to Oni Shrine Maidens and Mama Rabbit. Hello, Magic here and welcome back to another episode of Top 5 Toho Doujin Works. In this new series of mine, I'll be looking over any sort of Toho Doujin work I've encountered in the week, with you guys' suggestions as well. This way, we can all find something new to read and enjoy. So without further ado, let's begin the top 5 Toho Doujin works number 2. Number 5. Now we all know it's best not to mess with Yuka, or you're a dead motherfucker. But what if she was a baker? Well, it's still best not to mess with her, but I suggest you try out her bread. This work called The Bread's Ready, Yuka-san, created by Yuzu Momo, suggested by Little Sunflower. Tells the story of Sakuya making a trip to this bakery. It's there we learn that Yuka is running the place with a little help from Nidori. Here, we're shown that Yuka can make some bloody tasty breads, or I'm assuming anyway based on Sakuya's reaction. Either way, if you want to see Yuka in a bakery or Sakuya lamenting, this is something I recommend you to read. Number 4. Working can be annoying at times, no doubt about that. But if you're Parse, then the difficulty and nuisance of the job is raised by tenfold. This next one is a 4-panel strip by Fuinkei, or whatever the bloody Japanese name is I'm posting on the screen right now, suggested by Canned Psycho. In this story, we have Parse dealing with some regular or odd jobs. Let's just say working in the land of Gensokyo is no easy task. Let me show you some of the panels of the shit Parse has to deal with. That will be 356 yen total. Shall I warm it up for you? Make it warm and bubbly, just like us. Enjoy it before it cools off. Welcome. How may I serve you today? One hot chocolate and cafe latte, please. Put some ice in the chocolate, but don't put milk in the latte. I don't like it. Cappuccino and red tea, please. Cold red tea without milk. Oh, and last time there was a cinnamon smell from the cappuccino. Do something about that, won't you? Fuck this shit. Assuming the pay is even good, I still wouldn't take any of the jobs there. Number 3. In my intro, I mentioned about Mama Rabbit, which is what this next work will be about. This series is called Mama Unge, probably said it wrong, by Koyama Shigeru, suggested by Dat Lin. The story behind this is that Raisin is a mother of 3 kids. Kaguya being the oldest, Eren being the middle, and Tae being the youngest, and her everyday task of dealing with 3 handful little kids. While the girls may be small and adorable, Raisin has proven to us that raising 3 kids is no easy task. And in this story, we meet some of the other kids like Moku, Yukari, and Yuko, just to name a few. I'm warning you though, this story is not for the faint of heart. Those who are not prepared are gonna get struck down by this series' cuteness. Dynasty Reader has 6 chapters as of now. Dumbarrow at the moment has all the chapters and translated as well. And if you can't get enough of that, there's the reverse Mama Gin whatever series where Raisin is the kid and her mom is Eren. Number 2. In the series, we know that there are 2 shrine maidens, Reimu and Sane. But what if there was a 3rd one? Let's introduce the 3rd shrine maiden, Suika. The work is called Miko Miko Suika, created by the group called Hanawa's Store. So the story is about Suika wearing Reimu's shrine maiden clothes. Not only that, but we also follow Suika as she interacts with the humans at the village. Let's just say Suika is doing a better job than Reimu ever could. This is another long series as well, having 13 chapters. So if Suika being a shrine maiden sounds like your thing, then I suggest reading it up. Number 1. For those who don't know, Kane and Moku are good friends, being shown to have friendly interactions like in Cage and Lunatech and even a cameo in Wild and Horned Hermit. And there are tons of doujin work about these two. This next work, on the other hand, does things a bit differently. It's best if I just show you. Bring the ashtray over here.
Yes. I brought it over, Kane.
Looks like my shirt shrunk in this wash. Come here, I'll adjust it for ya.
Really?
Now where should I start cutting it off?
Ah, you meant fitting my body to the clothes instead.
Let's just say that Kane's affection for Moku is shown to be a bit radical from its usual depiction. The title is called
teach Ikukane. Fuck. That was annoying to try to say. Created by Gino. This ain't a work that's gonna be heartwarming, but it is funny. Let's be glad that Moku's immortal, or else this could have gotten worse. Wait a minute? Now that I think about it, it's because Moku's immortal that Kane can go all out on her. Sheet. Moku, you got it rough. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Which work are you gonna check after? Are you curious about Mama Raisin? Do you want to see Amiko Suika? Or does the thought of abusive Kane interest you? I want to say thank you again for you guys' suggestions, and I can't wait to see you guys in the next episode.